Hello guys, in this video, I'm going to show you how to create a custom control that have a multiple selecting with its two listbox. So you can use it reusable by drag and drop as a control in the window form application. So now I'm going to create window forms application and name project. Okay. So I'm going to create a user control and name the user control. Okay, I'm going to pick up a two listbox and two button. So just change the text for adding and copy the other button for removing from the listbox too. Okay. Now I'm going to rename that button for adding, okay? Button add. And this one for button remove. Okay. For listbox, I just keep it, just ignore it, because I have only two listbox, listbox 1 and listbox 2. And this one is just a create a property that get the item from the listbox 1, okay? Okay, it's got an error because of return type. Okay, this one for destination items for listbox 2. And I'm going to create event when we click the button add. So when we click it, I want the item from listbox 1. Remove and add it into the listbox 2. So I'm going to declare a variable and this one return as an object. So I just choose var keyword. You can specific data type something. Okay, now I'm going to get the index that I'm selecting on the item. Selected index. And then I'm going to remove the item add index that I am selected. Okay, then I'm going to add it into the listbox 2. Okay. Then I want it to default selected when I'm removing from the listbox 1. Okay. If you are not checking the condition, this might be have something error and index out of bound. Okay, now I'm going to test this. Test the control is work or not. Just create a form I already have, and then I'm just call the class, the user control class, and add it by coding. Add control directly to the form. Just draw the location for the location. Run this. Let's see. Alright. Okay. It's not yet work because I'm not yet at the item, sorry. I'm not yet at the items. So I'm going to put it a going to add a 10 elements. Okay, so I'm going to call the property in the control that I have created, source item, is a listbox one, okay? Add range. Okay, it's kind of converted the integer, so I'm going to change it into the string. Okay, string is object, and just plus with the string empty to convert the integer to string. Let's run it again, and you will see in listbox 1 have a 10 collection. Okay, I'm going to add it into the listbox. Okay, so we're going to remove it back when we select it in listbox 2. And just double click on that. And this one is almost the same, just change it. It means that just remove from the listbox 1 to add it into the listbox 2. And then when we want to remove, just remove from the listbox 2 and add it into the listbox 1. So just write the one method and just change the listbox right there. Okay, it's reusable. Okay, just from 2 again. So when we add it, just from listbox 1 and add it into listbox 2, okay? And for the remove button, from listbox 2 to the listbox 1. Okay, that's it. Now add it, and then I'm going to remove it, okay? Add it and remove it. You can sort the number, sort the item, it's up to you, but in this case, I'm not going to sort. So I'm going to create a class, for example, a class employee. So employee is the people, right? It is the person. It will be have a name, age, and the other properties, it's up to you, you can add it. Just for example, only the two property, and I'm going to add the employee into the listbox, okay? So I just change type to the employee type, employee class, and add it for 10 employees, set the name. Okay, let's run that, and if you see the type, it's unknown because I'm not yet set the display, okay, display member, which member that I want to display. So I'm going to set the property, set the method for this box display member from our control. Okay, it's just set the parameter name, the member, okay, and then I'm going to set the list box 1 display member as a member, okay, and listbox 2 too, and then I just copy the method and go to form, and then I'm going to set the member property is a name, so set member name, okay. If you show all the name of employee, okay. Okay, let's now I'm going to paste that. When I click the button in the form, I'm going to get the item from the list box 2. Just change the control into the glue box, so I can use the control object. Destiny item, okay. Destiny item. So we return the item from the listbox 2. Of type the extension, of type what? Of type employee, because I'm add the employee type into the listbox 2. So I need to set the type. And then I'm going to write the link shoe, select the name back. So name is returned as enumerable as a string, so just put it into that. And then I'm going to display it into the label 1. Okay, I'm called the string join, I mean that join concatenate the string into each other with the semicolon. So let's run that. Let's see. I'm going to add. And then click button. Okay. You get 4. Okay. Then remove 2. Maybe get 2. I'm going to delete that form because I want to create a library for user control, and then I'm going to reference that reference control that I can drag and drop. Just change the property, go to property. So now I'm going to change output type as a class library. Okay, rebuild it. I got an error, so I'm going to delete that one too, so it will not have any error. Okay, just do it again. Okay, rebuild done. So I'm going to open folder and go to debugs folder. Okay, we got a DLL file. Just copy that. Copy DLL file and pass it outside because I'm going to test that DLL file is well or not for my new project. Okay, and now I'm going to create an empty form. An empty form from the other project, okay? For test control selection. Hit OK and just save it. In toolbox, I'm going to add another tab for my control. Control for my control pad, okay? Control taste or something. And then I'm going to add items from my library, from the other file that I have copied. Just browse that file over here. Click on that. Okay, import done. And you can see that multi selection control. Okay, it's over here. Just drag and drop that. Okay, so you can use it whatever you want because you have create a property, add on, add and remove, or do some stuff inside that already. Okay, you can see the reference from the file. Okay.
If you have doubt something, just leave a comment down here and I will be respond as soon as possible. And finally, I really appreciate it if you hit subscribe button, click like this video, and see you guys in the next video. Goodbye.